holiness, it's what I need, yeah, yeah. Holiness, holiness, it's what you want.
Thank you, Jesus. The word tonight, by the help of God, is let this mind be in you. Tell somebody, let this mind be in you. And the top subtopic is, I'm changing it and I'm keeping it. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. And this is, it's the custom of society, or men in a whole, when the new year is approaching, we ask the, everybody want to make a resolution. Everybody want to change. Everybody wants a successful year. Some people want to change for the better. Some maybe want to change for the worse. I don't know, but there's always a want change. Somebody want change the new year. And while I was there, this word came to me. I was sleeping, and the Lord wake me up with this word. Let this mind be in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So let us take my time, and I go through with the mind. What the mind does, the mind controls the memory, the intention, the purpose, and inclination, God, of a man. It's the man's desires, his intellect, all his intelligence lie in a man's brain. It then is the control of the entire body, the mind control. God, if this microphone comes from the man's mind, it first have to be conceptualized in his mind. Hallelujah. Then he then would have to put it together, God, make plans, God, to create this microphone. So this microphone is a man's mind. It had to start in the control tower. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so it is that if we then, as children of God, our men and a whole, our mind, if we don't have a perfect mind, we can't have a perfect life. Oh God, tell somebody, you're gonna have to have a perfect mind to have a perfect life. Oh God, you gotta have a mind, hallelujah, that is in full capacity, working capacity. Oh God, I've working in the hospital, I've seen people who lose their minds. Lord of mercy. And all, hallelujah, that come through that mind is confusion. Shy God, thank you, Jesus. It's confusion. He's not able to process anything, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, that of none that makes sense. It's just nonsense that's come through the mind. And for in order for a man, hallelujah, to survive, his mind got to be in good state. God, in good sanity. He has to have a good sanity. You have to, God Almighty, think properly. And so when God created man, let us go back to the Old Testament to confirm the word. Amen? And that is that when God created man in his own image, God made man with a perfect mind. That's the intent, what God made man, God, to think properly. He was able to do everything right. Oh, Jesus. He was now, hallelujah, all that come through a man's mind was just good thoughts. Whatsoever thing was lovely, whatsoever thing was pure. Oh, God, what come? He doesn't know. He didn't know evil. Hallelujah. He didn't know evil. His mind was perfect. So that's why in that time he was in a state of innocence. Man didn't know evil. Oh, God, all he knew was good. Hallelujah. That's the mind that God created. Hallelujah. He created us in his own image and likeness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We were able to think pure. Man was able to think pure. He didn't know evil on God until the enemy came in and deceived man. And he eat of the tree. Hallelujah. Of the tree, good and evil. And then man eye opened. Hallelujah. And then he saw that he was naked. Hallelujah. And what man had was a polluted mind from that day. Thank you, Jesus. He had a mind of the Adamic system. Hallelujah. He was now able to do good and evil. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Tell somebody, let this mind be in you. God Almighty. So Jesus, hallelujah, the second Adam, hallelujah, came to restore the mind. Tell somebody, he came to restore your mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So what he did, he died, hallelujah, and he condemned sin in the flesh. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And why he did that, he gave us, hallelujah. That's why when a man come to God, he got to renew his mind. Oh God, hallelujah. He got to transform his mind, not after this world, his system, not after the Adamic nature, hallelujah, but he got to renew his mind by the word of God. Thank you, Jesus, and the washing of the word of God. So God want to bring us back to our original state of mind. Oh, Jesus. You want to take us back to the original state of thinking where he intended us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And so Paul, the writer, was then saying to the brethren, let this mind be in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Before we reach that, there is a struggle to keep the mind. Hallelujah. Thank you. When we work, my mind is transformed, man of God. There is a struggle to keep the mind. That's why Paul said, oh God Almighty, there is a warring, oh God, in my member, bringing back my mind. Want to bring back our mind into captivity. It's a daily war to keep the mind. When the mind is transformed, it's a war. That's why Paul said, every time I try to do good, Shakai, but tell somebody, God, let this mind be in you. Thank you, Jesus. And everybody want to change it. Everybody want to be better Christian, better walker. But if the mind is not right, Lord, I don't feel like I shot it tonight. But I want to talk, hallelujah, about the mind, the mind, the mind, the mind. Hallelujah, the mind got to be right. In order for a man to get rid of his fear, if he doesn't get it in his mind, he will be fearful until the day he die. But first, in order for him to get rid of his fear, he got to get it in his mind, and I'm not afraid anymore. Shakai, tell somebody, I'm getting it right to face the God. Hallelujah. In holiness is a lifestyle. If I don't get it in the mind, if I don't get the mind of Christ, I can't live it. It's impossible, God Almighty, to have your mind, the carnal mind. The Bible said the carnal mind is anything against God. It opposed God. The carnal mind, it opposed the things of God. Shakai. And we cannot move forward with a carnal mind. And if your mind is not spiritual, it's carnal. There's no gray areas. Lord, it's either black or white. If your mind is carnal, you got to change it before 2016. Tell somebody, change your mind. No more carnal mind. And so it is that God, Jesus, in his wisdom, greatest teacher, he said, listen to me, it's not what, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, it's not what go down defile a man. It's what comes out, hallelujah. What's in your mind? Oh, Jesus, my Holy Ghost. What's in your mind tonight? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm not judging you. It's your manifestation. It's what's in your mind you're going to manifest. We can pretend all we want. My mother always reminds us, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, that there always, you can pretend, but you cannot do it for long. You can't, the truth is like oil. And you can't mix oil and water. Oil always surface. What's in your mind tonight? So you might come to church every night, every Bible teaching, every Sunday worship, fellowship with the saints, but you have some things in your mind that you need to get out. And you got to have the mind of Christ. Let this mind be in you.
And Jesus is a wise God. He does not mess with free will. God doesn't hold anybody. When he calls you, you answer. He said, I am at the door, knocking. If any man, if any man hear and just open it, then I will come in. Shaka. And I have fellowship. I will sup with you, man. I show you things. You can't have a carnal mind and go, hallelujah, the place in God. It's an enmity. You can't go nowhere with the carnal mind. God needs us to have the mind of Christ. And so let this mind be in you. And so there is, hallelujah, a warring. There is a warring. There is a warring in this member, in this body, in this mind. Hallelujah. Every now and then the devil show up. Now God is in this Adamic system. Self is in me. It doesn't want God. It doesn't want the things of God. It's a constant warring. That's why Paul said, I die daily. Tell somebody daily, man. Daily, daily. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's a daily thing. It's a daily giving up. It's a daily surrendering. It's a daily sacrifice. And so it is that Jesus now being our example. Gotta rush it. Gotta rush it. Being our example. Saying, let this mind be in you. What he was talking. He made himself of low repetition. Tell somebody low. Lord Jesus. Nobody, it's hard for people to be humble in the house now. Lord Jesus. Even you're a carnal man. Hallelujah. You're in your pomp and your pride. But if God, the only wise God, make himself as low and humble. Tell somebody, this is the mind God wants in you. Oh God Almighty. Humble mind. Tell somebody, humble, humble, humble. Humble, humble, humble. The form, he take on the form of a servant. Lord, nobody want to serve. Lord Jesus. Everybody want to be served. But if the King of Glory, the only true wise God, make himself a servant, tell somebody, let this mind be in you. Are you ready for this mind to be in you? Tell somebody, he made himself of low. And he made himself, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, in the form of a servant. Oh, God, the mind make you serve. Umber, umber, shaka, irubasai. And then what he did was then made in the likeness of man, fashion himself in man, the King of Kings, make himself low and fashion himself in a man. That's all low. The Lord used, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. He came, hallelujah, and went in a manger. That's all God wanted us to be humble. He goes, he didn't choose the palace. He went into a manger. Manger, low. Thank you, Jesus. Tell somebody, just for me. How many persons ready to go low? Low, low, umbra, umbra, umbra. Thank you, Jesus. That's the mind that God wants for us.
That's right.
In a manger he went. He become obedient unto death. God said, I'm looking for some people that are obedient, ready to give up everything, woman of God, even unto death. Lord Jesus, that's the mind. Tell somebody, that's the mind, man. That's the mind. That's the mind for 2016. That's the mind for God. Lord Jesus, going to lead us to the to a life of holiness. Tell somebody, even unto death. The mind make us to do the will of God, even if it costs our lives. Yes. Lord Jesus, is anybody ready?
That's right.
Let this mind be in you. Humble, ready to do the will of God. Without a wife, Lord Jesus. I wish I don't lose her, but if I lose her, Oh, God Almighty, I wish I don't lose my sons. But even unto death, God has, and saints of God, and God is a just God. There is nothing for us to lose when we humble ourselves. There is nothing for us to do when we humble ourselves unto death to do the will of God. Well, guess what? He said, he was exalted and give him a name. Lord Jesus, tell somebody it's time to get the mind. Don't worry about the exalting. Don't worry about the be lifted up. You just do what you have to do. Just humble. And God going to lift you up. Tell somebody, let this mind. Come on, is somebody need that mind? I need that mind. Shaka. That's a mind of success. That's a mind of greatness. I need that mind. Let it be. Let it be in you. This mind. This mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And God give him a name. God go and lift your mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And every knee shall bow. Everything. Don't worry about the exaltation. What the carnal mind does, it exalts itself against God. And what it does, it gives a form of godliness. Oh God, we're moving from a form. Oh God, we need the real thing. That's why a man has to get it right in the mind. In order for you to manifest, you got to get it in the mind. The devil not going to stop this. I'm changing my mind from tonight. I need the mind of Christ. I need to think like Christ. I need to operate like Christ. Does somebody get it in the mind? Jesus. For such then as Christ had suffered for us in the flesh. Tell somebody, come, let us read it together. For as Christ as in the arm yourself with the, tell somebody the same mind. Jesus, help me, Holy Ghost. Tell somebody the same mind. Hey, Loba Saka, the same mind. I read verse 2. That then no. In the lust, the will of God, Lord Jesus. Tell somebody, arm yourself. Arm yourself, man. Arm yourself likewise with the same mind. Now tell somebody, let the same mind to Jesus. And so you got to understand that Jesus came to suffer in the flesh. Lord, nobody want to suffer. They start looking at me strange now. You got to suffer in the flesh. Lord, Jesus suffer in the flesh. Thank God to condemn sin in the flesh that we might live in righteousness, not after the law, hallelujah, but in the righteousness of God. Tell somebody, righteousness of Christ. And so it is that we have to arm ourselves to suffer in the flesh. We're going to suffer some things in the flesh. Tell somebody, that's all right. If I suffer in the flesh, flesh has been crucified. And if flesh is being crucified, then the righteousness of God is about to rise up in me. Tell somebody, arm yourself with the same mind. So Christ came and suffered for us in the flesh. We got to arm ourselves likewise with the same mind. He suffered in the flesh and has ceased from sin. He no longer, Lord Jesus, live his rest of the time in the flesh, but after the will of God. Is anybody ready, hallelujah, to suffer some things in the flesh? Lord Jesus, so flesh might die. Lord Jesus, that the will of God might be manifest in me. Lord Jesus, tell somebody, man, are you ready? Are you ready? If you're not ready to make the suffering through 2016, it's holiness, we said, right? Not as a lifestyle. They say you got to suffer in the flesh. Feel so uncomfortable. Discomfort in the flesh. Pain in the flesh. Lord God Almighty, do some night and day fasting, you know, to suffer the fresh man. Do some night and day fasting. If you used to do 2 weeks, 2 days per week, double it, man, do 4. Tell somebody, I'm going to suffer this flesh. Jesus, tell somebody, crucify the flesh, man. It must die. We can get up every day, Lord Jesus, and live, hallelujah, doing the things that gratify the flesh and live holy. You can't get up every day, Lord Jesus, Lord God Almighty, and living off of the flesh, feeding the flesh, man. So let's what? So instead of I'm reading the Bible, I'm on Facebook all day, the devil's a liar. Lord Jesus, how can I be on television all day and want to live holy? The devil a liar. I got to arm myself with the same mind, man, to suffer this flesh. Oh God, when the devil came up to tempt with King Jesus, he said, all these I give to you. If you bow down and worship, you got to have something in your spirit to fight against the flesh. You got to say, it is written, man shall live not by bread alone, but every word that prostrates somebody. Are you ready to suffer in the flesh? So Christ condemned it. So we got to arm ourselves with the same mind. Shakabasaka. Is anybody ready? Sins of the Most High God, it's got to move from lip service. It's time to stop the talking. It is too much talking. A, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It's time now to manifest what's in your mind. You got to manifest. Oh, God, what's in your mind? You got to manifest. If you sow to the... Oh, God, tell somebody. If you sow to the flesh... that you shall reap the things of the flesh, but if you sow to the spirit, you shall reap things of the spirit. Tell somebody, what's in your mind? What's your mind? Is your mind spiritual? Is the same mind that is in Christ Jesus? Oh God Almighty, is it in you? And they said, I'm gonna keep this mind, knowing this, that God had made a way of escape. In every situation, he had made a way of escape. If we're going to beat, we got to get it right. And where it begins in the thought process. It begins in the mind. All my desires, all that I hope to be, all that I'm going to be, it starts in the mind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And if I can suffer in this flesh and to condemn the works of the flesh, that the will of God may be accomplished in me. Tell somebody, I'm ready to keep this mind. Let this mind be in you. And so because there's a war to keep this mind, tell somebody, I'm changing it. Tell somebody, I'm changing the old Adamic mind. I'm changing it, and I'm going to fight to keep it. Tell somebody, keep it. Lord Jesus, January, I'm going to keep this mind. In February, I'm going to keep it. Oh God, tell somebody, I want this mind to be in me. Oh God, I want to see Jesus. He brought me thus far, not to leave me. What I need is a sanctification in my spirit, but I got to begin in my mind. But if I'm just press along and I press towards the things of God, if I then let this mind be in me, I know I'm gonna be holy, I know I'm gonna be right, I know I shall see Jesus. I don't care what the skeptics say, I might lose some some friends, they might say I'm playing, what I'm professing, but I'm going to change the mind. I got to go in some depths what God taking me. I got to go in some higher heights and some deeper depths. I'm tired of the lukewarmness. I want to get on fire for God. Is anybody want to get on fire? Is anybody want to live holy? Is anybody want to live right? Tell somebody, change your mind. Change your mind. Change your way of thinking. Change your carnal mind. Get spiritual in your mind. Get spiritual in your thoughts. Tell somebody, victory is yours if you change your mind. The anointing is yours if you change your mind. Tell somebody, change your mind. Change your mind. That mind is that mind what you have is a limitation. But if you get the minds of Christ, you shall soar in higher heights, deeper depths. Lord of mercy. Tell somebody, keep the mind.
The mind of Christ. I'm done here in Jesus' name. But my word to you, saints of the Most High God, it's what's in you, you're going to manifest. It's what's in your mind, you're going to manifest. And Jesus came to restore you back into your original state of mind. Hallelujah. That's why Paul said, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things have good report. If there be any praise, Lord Jesus, Elobasakai, if there be any honor, if there be anything, any good thing come to you, Elobas, any virtue, think on those things. Shakai, Elobasakai. Come on, stand everywhere in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Tell somebody, I'm going into the new year with a new mind. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God, if the people of God will get this word tonight in your spirit, that your way, your way of success in this Christian walk, where you got to get the mind of Christ. And some of you, you know that you have some mind at our corner that is stopping the progress. Hallelujah. God can't download some stuff in you because your mind is opposing God. Oh God, he said you need to get this mind. Your way forward is to get the mind of Christ. Tell somebody, I'm changing it. And I'm keeping it, Lord Jesus. Not only change it, but there's a fight to keep it. Tell somebody, I'm gonna keep it. Hallelujah. I'm going forward in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It's not a rule. We're not telling you, hallelujah, holiness as a scribe and the Pharisees. Jesus said, you got to pass the scribe and the Pharisees. You got to come to relationship. Hallelujah. It's got to come to knowing God. Hallelujah. But you got to understand that mind that you have, that carnal mind, is stopping the process. But we got to have the mind of Christ. Tell somebody, I claim the mind of Christ. Hello, Masakai. Come on, tell somebody, I claim the mind of Christ. Hallelujah. I'm arming myself likewise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. That same mind to suffer. Oh God, we're going to condemn sin in the flesh. He did it for us. For us to, Lord God Almighty, to live unto righteousness. But tell somebody, it's time to change it and keep it in Jesus' name.
You know what's in your mind. You know exactly what is going on in your mind. You know what you're thinking in your mind. That same struggle that you want to get over, you got to start it in your mind. That that same hurt, that same pain that you're feeling, it's all in your mind. And the only way to deal with what you're going through, you got to start to change your mind. Watch your thoughts, because your thoughts become your words, and your words become your character, and your character become your destiny. You want to get your past. Start to work on your mind. You know those times that you and I spend reflecting and thinking to ourselves in our minds? Hear what the psalmist said. The psalmist says, even when there is not a word in my know it all together. When I sit us down and I'm thinking to myself, you know it, what's going on in my mind. You want to overcome? Start in your mind. Because it's with the mind we serve God. The word is so right. Amen. Praise God. A few nights ago, I promised myself some things, and I mark an X. You know, you always mark an X. He said, I'm never going to do it again. Amen. Praise God. Tell somebody, mark the X here. Right here. I'm going to change it. And I'm going to keep the change. It doesn't matter what. You have to fix it in your mind. If I don't fix it in my mind, there is no way I'm going to come out. I'm going to be trapped in my mind. But I need to fix it in my mind. I need to fix it in my mind. You know, you want someone to come and say something to you, but it's about, hallelujah, we start to talk like what the psalmist said. He said, oh soul. Come on now. Say, oh my. Why? Because the mind. And if your mind is not right, your worship is tainted. Your praise is tainted. And every offering that you give is tainted. So you got to get it first right in your mind. I'm about to change it. Can I say this? Also, it doesn't mean that because I say it in my mind, I'm going to change it, that there's not going to be days when I'm struggling to change it. There's not going to be days when I'm not going to get it right. But as long as I mark the X and say, I'm going to do it. in the name of Jesus, I'm going to change my mind. Come on, you got to believe it. I'm going to change my mind. And I got to get the mind of Christ. And the only way is to change your mind. The only way you can able to have a blessing unless you change your mind. Come on, stand up.
So take my hope.